Everybody calling me late. I'm not late. What's up, guys? I am James Hake. This is the Hake Report. It's 9:02 a.m. It doesn't count. It's not. Okay, it's 9:03 a.m. U.S. Pacific Daylight Time. I'm on time. I should switch my official time start to 9:05. Is your watch broken, Hake? Man. And it's Monday, April 26th, the year of our Lord, 2021. Hake been hanging with them colors so long, that's why he's on CP time. Just like, what's her name? Didn't Hillary Clinton call herself, I guess I was on CP time. I can picture her saying it. Maybe I'm confusing her for somebody else. Nice wind sound effects. Thank you. No, I do not smoke pot. But I do have another excellent hand-picked song for you. Some of you wish that I would go back to the metal music. Some of you are glad that's over, maybe. No more metal music, says Skip. I have some hand-picked Christian punk rock for you. Is it pop punk? Probably. What else is enjoyable, right? Nah. This is Ghoti. It is a Christian band, courtesy of Tooth and Nail, 1997 or so. This song is called Esteban, with a, or maybe it's pronounced Esteban, because it has a V, and the V sounds like a hard B to the Hispanics. Enjoy this song, and we'll get started, and I will be taking your calls, guys. Here it comes. Very nice. Oh, is it echoing? It's echoing, huh? Yeah, it's echoing. What a mess. At least for me. Yeah. Yeah, that's terrible. Let's turn it off. Forget it. Oh, did you fix it? I don't know. Okay. Anyway, guys, false start. We'll skip that thing. I'm kind of liking Hank's torture, says Jim Justice. What a mess. For some reason, it was echoing in my ears. No echo here. Sounds better, says Jim Justice. I don't know. But it was definitely echoing on my end. So it's too distracting for me. No echo on stream, says Nick. Well, thank you, man. Audio seems fine on stream. Hake has awful taste on music. Ozzy is better. What? Anyway, guys, I don't know. We'll get that worked out. Cut the music. It is 9:05 anyway here in Los Angeles. Maybe we can work it out for the top of the next hour. Let's find out if the intro song skips or echoes. That's a good question. I guess we'll find out. You guys can call in 888-775-3773. I'm going to be talking about Black Rhino Tim Scott. The Armenian Genocide, finally recognized by one of the most evil men in America and the world today. And more fake drama over the police violence. They're dogpiling on Derek Chauvin. And on and on and on it goes. So let's get right on with the show.
1, 2, 3, oh, yeah. 4. Oh, it's the Hake Report.
So you guys probably don't hear the echo. Press 1 if it's perfect. Press 2 if it's echoing for you. It's echoing for me.
Hey guys!
It's terrible. No, this is bad. You gotta turn it off. You know why you have to turn it off? Just turn it off. So, how are you all doing? Did you check, Nick, did you check the audio feed? Because the audio feed, they are important too. Very important. Shout out to Trevor Wesley, who did the thing. Do that thing. But the reason that I cut that song off, guys, is because when I can hear it echo, even if you can't hear it echo, you guys on the video feed, the people on the audio feed may well hear it echo. So, and the people on the live audio feed are not usually in the live video chat. So, just a heads up, I have a feeling that it was doing that. So, what a mess. It makes me wonder. Let me jump right over to this story on Derek Chauvin. There was this story of this Derek Chauvin guy, this cop from Minneapolis, Minnesota, former cop, who kneeled on the shoulder blade slash neck of that man, and I use the term man loosely, Georgia, Florida. Sleazy TMZ is dogpiling on Derek Chauvin, and so are the whole rest of the people. They've been dogpiling on him for, I don't know, going on a year. And Chauvin is in solitary confinement. Maybe for his safety a little bit. But they're also just coming down extra hard on him. He's a symbol of white supremacy. That's the reason that they're going after him so badly. There was actually video that was supposedly released of Chauvin brutalizing a black teenager in like 2017 or so. Oh no! Dealing with the rough people. A mother, I think, called the cops on her teenage son, 14-year-old black teenager. And maybe her daughter, too. A woman had called the police for help, this is according to TMZ, after she said that she was attacked by her 14-year-old son and daughter. Chauvin arrived. He ordered the boy to get on the ground. When he refused, Chauvin allegedly hit him with a flashlight as he grabbed his throat. Allegedly used a neck restraint that held for so long the teen lost consciousness. I don't know, young men who are raised by mothers to get the boys out of control, they can be pretty wild. 14-year-olds can be pretty big too, by the way. The prosecutor who reviewed the video says eight minutes in, Chauvin changed positions and put his knee on the teen's back for another 9 minutes. So he's on top of him for 17 minutes. And the guy was saying, I can't breathe. So typical. It's under criminal investigation, but they don't know if they're going to charge him criminally. But they're piling on to this guy. It allegedly shows Chauvin violently subduing the teen. The violent teen, you might add, fairly. Viciously striking him in the head with such force that he needed stitches to close the wound. Well, stop calling the cops on blacks. Blacks? Am I right? Chauvin allegedly held him down to the ground with his knee for 17 minutes as he gasped for air, oblivious to the teen's cry that he couldn't breathe. And he's facing, according to TMZ, TMZ is a far-left, sleazy, radical homosexual, anti-white, anti-Christian outlet. They like to stir up trouble. Derek Chauvin faces 40 years behind bars. Not going to get 40 years. I would be shocked. For murdering Georgia, Florida. Which is false. But that may be just the beginning because there's another incident that is eerily similar to the killing of George Floyd. So they're talking about this case. But I have this. This is rich. And hopefully the audio comes clearly for me. And for the audio feed. This is also from TMZ. And it was also reported in The Hill and New York Post. Because this is a 60 Minutes video clip. CBS runs 60 Minutes. Minnesota Attorney General. I don't know if I want to play this, actually. Keith Ellison. Let me just kind of reenact and paraphrase what Keith Ellison said, because I don't even think I want to take the chance. Keith Ellison is that communist Muslim liar. He swore when he was at one point a congressman, a so-called congressman for the United States out of Minnesota, and he swore, you know how you swear in? He swore in on a Quran, not on a Bible, because he's anti-Christian. He's a Muslim, a black one, and a radical. He's not even, like, that black. He's light-skinned, kind of. And those are the ones that you really have to watch out for sometimes. Except for Benjamin Crump. He's pretty dark, and he's evil, too. But this guy is such a typical anti-Christian. Minnesota Attorney General Keith Ellison says he felt a little bad for Derek Chauvin after the verdict. And he felt justified and all these things. He's being interviewed by that sleazy guy, Scott Pelley. Scott Pelley is a CBS reporter guy. CBS / 60 Minutes. Wannabe pretend like he's an objective person. Scott Pelley. And same thing with this guy, a phony. Keith Ellison. Wasn't he an Obama guy? He might have been. Keith Ellison? Anti-Christian guy. He uses the buzzword that, oh, he's human. We're all human. George Floyd was a human. And we wanted justice. This was about justice. Should he get the maximum sentence? He should get the right sentence, not heavy or light. Crump is making millions, says Jim Justice. Yeah. Minnesota Attorney General, so-called Attorney General, this guy's not, doesn't care about the law. Yeah, we can't rewind a check. I'm pretty sure that the audio feed people were having, were probably experiencing the echo that I was hearing. This reminds me of, he says, we're all human. It reminds me of Cornel West. Remember that wild-haired, wild-eyed, bug-eyed, weird communist guy? Black guy? He pretends like he's fair-minded. He was, I think he appeared in an interview on censored.tv or something like that. Whatever Gavin McInnes started with Milo or something like that. Cornel West pretending that he's a fair-minded person. He's not. He was like, oh, we can't dehumanize the racists. They are human too. But except calling somebody racist is in itself dehumanizing, so they're talking out of both sides of their mouths. We can't dehumanize the inhuman racists. That's Cornel West. That is Keith Ellison. And that is that fake, this is the communist part of it. They have this fake compassion for these people that they railroad. Derek Chauvin. Oh, he was, they railroad him, and then they say, oh, I feel bad for him. This is not something to celebrate. He's human too. We just wanted pure justice. This was not about revenge for, against Derek Chauvin. But he's just pretending to be about justice. He's also pretending to feel, I mean, he probably does feel emotional, because he's an emotional person. Gets into fights with women, by the way. He can't get along with, anyway, that's a side note. Just paying lip service and saying the right words. The fake right words, though. Zero meaning to it. You can't be, if you're an attorney general, you're emotionally detached. You're not all emotional and compassionate for either the so-called victim or the perpetrator. But this guy is playing both sides. Yeah, Cornel West with that self-righteous indignation. Isn't Cornel West a communist too? This Keith Ellison guy took a selfie with a Antifa book in like 2017 and said, this book strikes fear in the heart of Donald Trump. I think he might have been congressman at that point. I'm not sure. And his son too. Keith Ellison's son is some official in the city of Minneapolis, if I remember right. Somewhere around there. And he said, oh, I am Antifa. I am in Antifa. By the way, these people are shameless. This black radical Maxine Waters says that the judge, the trial judge, is way off track. You know that judge who said, I wish that these politicians would keep their comments to themselves. And Maxine Waters saying that he's absolutely guilty. Coming into town and saying, oh, he's absolutely guilty. And we want nothing else but guilt and get more confrontational if it's not a guilty verdict. That's what Maxine Waters said, the black female. With a $4 million home, or however many millions of dollars home she has down here. Maxine Waters caused the judge way off track. She's way off track, but she's so way off track so long that she thinks that he's off track. I don't know if she really thinks that, but she's just saying it. That's what they do. Shamelessness works when you're for evil. And if you're actually for good, shamelessness works for you too. That's why it worked for Trump. Because he was shameless, but yet right. Appropriate. Linya and Chin with a colorful chat on Trovo says, Keith, meaning Ellison, is objective. His objective is clear to me. Destruction of Western civilization use via the use of lies like racism. That's right. What was racist about Derek Chauvin's knee on the neck? Nothing. Nothing. What was inappropriate about it? What was excessive about it? I don't know. I don't know if anything was. It was within the rules. Jenner will save California from the wickedness, says Den Tietjen. Nope. What a mess. I never knew James Brown was trans. Whoa, Paul Robertson. Is that a reference to what Bill O'Reilly said about Maxine Waters? Anyway, Maryland is going to be probing the Chauvin witness. A defense witness, actually. His tenure as the state's chief medical examiner. What a shame. Dr. David Fowler is a retired forensic pathologist and former chief medical examiner for the state of Maryland. He testified in the trial of Derek Chauvin for the defense. But now he's getting investigated. They're lynching everybody who tried to stand on what's right. Remember that cop who, I think a former cop, right? Former cop from somewhere in NorCal, I believe it was. He testified that was not unreasonable use of force or something like that. He was a use of force expert. He went from cop to use of force expert. And he testified for the defense, I believe. And then they put pig's blood and a severed pig head on his porch. Only it wasn't his porch anymore because he'd moved out years before that. And so Antifa, Black Lives Matter scumbags calling cops pigs and vandalizing a home. Talk about terrorism. Talk about intimidation. And it was criminal vandalism too, felony vandalism, because it was more than $400 worth of damage, right? Sick stuff. They did that to that witness. Now the state of Maryland is investigating this guy Fowler. What's his name again? Dr. David Fowler. He was tapped by Chauvin defense attorney Eric Nelson to testify and provide his expert opinion. Testify that Floyd's cause of death could have been attributed to a myriad of factors. Duh! They include heart disease or the fact that Floyd was under the influence of drugs, three times the amount of fentanyl in his system that it takes to kill the average man or male or person. Fowler said if he had been the medical examiner in Hennepin County, Minnesota, where Floyd died, he would have ruled his death as undetermined. Yeah. The official so-called determination was homicide by law enforcement restraint. Give me a break. And then you have the communists who call into the show saying, that was homicide. There's no reasonable doubt. No, there's reasonable doubt. But they're calling it murder, and manslaughter. What a shame. They've taken steps to wall off those in our office who are representing the Office of the Chief Medical Examiner, its current and former employees, including Dr. Fowley, from the investigation. He stands by his work as the state's chief examiner. People need to do what they need to do, but there's a large team of forensic pathologists with layers of supervision, and those medical examiners always did tremendous work. He didn't make any comments about his testimony in the Chauvin trial, though. Crazy, huh? It's ridiculous. Trying to make everybody who's said the truth at all, make them delegitimized. What a shame. Am I right? Anyway, I gotta get to some calls. I will be talking about this Armenian genocide thing. They've been pushing for it for a long time. We've had people on the show, on the Jesse Lee Peterson show when I was producer, to talk about this Armenian genocide from over 100 years ago, 1915 or something like that? April 24th? Crazy. And I will read your super chats as well. Streamlabs.com/TheHakeReport. Thank you guys for the support. Some little ethnic child gave us a Streamlabs donation and said, "Great to see you, Hake. How was your weekend?" It was excellent. It was great. Had a chill sábado, which means Sabbath, which means Saturday in Spanish. So that was cool. And then Sunday was great. Church with Jesse Lee Peterson. I help make sure that it goes out on air. Well, basically, I'm here, and I let Bill make sure it goes out. Bill, the black engineer, shout out. And the rest of these guys, the volunteers. And it was a cool thing. And more super chats from you guys. Hang tight. I will get to you. But Killian in Boston, Massachusetts is checking in here. Killian, how are you doing?
I've been better.
Yeah? What's up?
Yeah, I miss you guys. I just got out of the hospital. I was trapped in the hospital for 2 weeks.
Wow. You told me that you were going to be trapped in there. Weren't going to be able to...
Yeah, I had to get some of my intestines removed for cancer, but it was successful, and now I'm 100% cancer-free.
Wow. Well, congratulations, man. And you're a young man, right?
Yeah, I'm early 30s.
Yeah. Well,
but it was, I gotta say, it was miserable. It was the most painful experience of my entire life. And
physically painful.
I went 12 days without eating food or drinking water.
Yeah.
I was just living on IV bags and shots of morphine. It was horrible.
Wow. That is wild. That is an ordeal.
I just had to lay on my back for like 2 weeks and I couldn't even roll onto my side or else it was just like excruciating pain. But
ooh. Yeah,
I finally passed it, and I'm back home now. I'm listening to you guys in the morning.
And wow.
And let you know I'm doing all right.
Yeah, I'm glad to hear it. That's sort of a quick healing, although you probably have to be ginger with yourself.
Yeah, the doctor said that I'm not allowed to lift more than 10 pounds for 6 weeks.
Wow, okay.
And
that's fair.
I was supposed to start a brand new job next week, which is one of those jobs that you're required to lift up to 50 pounds. So I got to give them a call here in a little bit and break the bad news to them. But they're really nice. I don't know what they're going to do because I already accepted the job like over a month ago.
Yeah.
I told them, I'm like, hey, I got to go get surgery. And they're very conducive towards that. They're like, that's fine. We'll just push off your start date. But they've been pushing my start date off for like a month now.
Yeah.
And today I have to call them up and be like, another 6 weeks.
Yeah.
So I don't know what they're going to do. But to be fair, the labor market right now is real tight. Like everywhere I see driving around, everyone's looking help wanted for everywhere.
Yeah.
And especially with my skill set as an electrician, it's tough to find anyone.
Well, so, I hope you're able to get back to work as soon as you're ready.
Yeah. I mean, on the plus side, I got unemployment benefits until September, so I'm trying not to just be a welfare queen.
Right.
But I mean, I don't know.
Man, that's pretty brutal, though.
Your digestive system is basically your life. Like, I mean,
true.
If your digestive system fails. And
if you haven't got your health, you haven't got anything.
Basically.
Yeah.
So, Whew. Hopefully that'll work out. The only problem with that is 6 weeks, my dad's planning on driving up from Florida to visit. So it would be really tough to start a brand new job and have my dad move in for his little summer vacation, because he's quite the party animal. He drinks a lot and smokes a lot. And
well, he'll have to get under control.
I don't know. My fiance, she doesn't want him to stay here, and I'm kind of siding with her, but
she's living with you still?
My dad. What's that?
She's living with you still?
Yeah. Yeah, Maine. We're still living together. Well, I mean, where we live, I'm on Cape Cod, and the rent here is ridiculous. So it basically takes two incomes if you want to live in a one-bedroom condominium, you know?
Wow. I wish you well.
Pretty much $2,000 a month.
Yeah.
Plus utilities. So.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah. And everyone's saying how the summer is going to be crazy here, because pretty much all the summer rentals are booked for the entire summer, and the prices are all up by 30%. Because everyone's trying to escape the cities. They all want to come down to Cape Cod.
Yeah. Man, what a mess.
Get away from the China virus, you know?
Yeah. Well, what to do.
I like to call it the political virus.
Yeah, I mean, that's very politicized. And then they accuse us of politicizing it. They're such communists.
Well, it's like they always accuse you of what they're doing.
Yep, that's true.
It's just so frustrating. It's the term gaslighting has become more and more popular these days.
Yeah, I know. It's so popular that they're accusing us of doing it. It's shameful.
Gaslighting, dog whistling.
Yeah,
they get all these funny terms.
Yep, Killian, man. I don't know, man. You got to get it together.
Well, I mean, it's just a matter of time, you know. Time heals all wounds.
But it's not going to just heal itself when you're. Don't you know better than to live with your girlfriend?
Yeah, I know better. It is what it is. We don't have sex or anything. We're more roommates than anything, to be honest.
I mean,
I cook dinner here and there and help her with chores, with rent and whatnot. But I've heeded Jesse's advice.
Okay.
I see when she's trying to treat me like she's my mother, and I rebuff her, and she gets pissed, and I'm just like, whatever.
Was she a fiance last I talked to you?
Yeah.
Okay. Because I thought that you'd referred to her as a girlfriend beforehand.
Well, it's interchangeable. I mean, we've been together for about 9 years, so we basically act like an old married couple, but...
Huh. Well, man...
Modern society and clown world takes its toll on all of us, I suppose.
Yeah. Well, keep doing right.
I will.
I wish you well, Killian.
I just wanted to give you the heads up.
I definitely appreciate it.
I haven't called in a long time.
Yeah.
Let you know I'm still alive.
Good. And breathing. Barely.
and using the toilet.
Man. TMI. Thanks, man. Take care.
All right. You as well.
All right. Wow. I remember he said that he was going to have a surgery. No, Nick, I want him to come in here to see if he can just see what the issue is, what setting is wrong. Bill. Art in Ohio wants to talk about broken families. What's up, Art? How you doing?
Hey, how you doing, Hank? How you doing?
Doing well, thank you. Good to hear from you.
Well, okay, let's go to that Chauvin thing. You said that another incident ago, a mom called the police.
Yeah.
Because both the son and the daughter was getting out of line, so she called them. She couldn't even get her own kids under control. So when he come around there, and more than likely when the cop comes around there, he got to deal with a disrespectful little girl and a disrespectful little boy that was brought up by a disrespectful mother.
You're right.
So what do you expect to happen if there is no dad in the house and there hasn't been any form of discipline that the man is supposed to put down in the house, or even if they ain't living around them, or, you know, even if the dad ain't living around, he might be living down the street. If a kid ain't got no type of real male kids don't have no type of real discipline from the father, not their mom, because the moms only know how to coddle and, oh, come here, and let me do this. And then when they are aggressive with the kids, they are overly look aggressive because
right.
they try to fill in where the men left off, and they can't because they're females. So with the caller that called in on Jesse, he was talking about he didn't want to let his kid go, and Jesse was like, let him go or whatnot. And it's like, well, if we let the kids go, what's the difference between giving up? That's like giving up on this election or whatnot, or
yeah,
or the MyPillow guy fighting for what's right. If we don't start standing up and fighting for what's right, knowing that the Democrats is politicizing these custody and family courts, using these kids as a voting block or part of the prison, the pipeline. You see what I'm saying? Because we know that if the dad ain't in the house, there are chances of them going to jail or higher. Then if the dads ain't in the house, or the dads ain't even involved in the houses or the families because the courts, then we know that leaves the Democrats an open voting block. Because we all know that when the kids is brought up around females, they tend to vote Democrats.
Yeah, fair point. Did you hear Jesse Lee Peterson's call with that guy Tony from New York City at the end of the hour over there?
Yeah, I heard.
So you disagreed with Jesse still on that?
Always, yep. Because if we give up on this fight, we got to give up on every fight, and that's what I can't stand about the.
Well, it's more about picking your battles. Being wise.
I agree with you, but. This is the battle that you need to be we need to be picking. You know what I mean? And if I can't be too hard on the Republicans, if I'm a pushover just like them.
But that's not necessarily being a pushover, that's being wise with your fight and your resources and your energy.
Okay, well let's be wise then. Okay, well let's go ahead and be wise. If we already see what's going on with China as far as their birth rate, and as far as meaning that the older people, they ain't reproduce enough kids, so that's why China is falling in decline. That's gonna be that's the same thing that's going over here in America. So
yeah.
I feel like this is the correct cause, because if it's not, we don't stand up and fight for this. Then America's not only done because the Democrats is crazy, but we gonna start turning, which we already are turning into a non-reproductive state, meaning we ain't producing kids. And
yeah.
American kids, how we post to, because a lot of the alpha males like me and you, we see what's going on, and that deters us away from having kids. While LaBeta James is having all the kids that he want, preaching that communist socialist stuff. Him and Maxine Waters, I'm listening.
Yeah, man. But like what Jesse Lee Peterson said, when that guy did wrong, and when you did wrong. In having the kid, I forget whether it was out of wedlock or it was not a good situation, and she divorced, and now she's, pardon the phrase, but screwing you guys over and screwing their own kids over, the women doing that. It was already, you know, the battle was already lost when you did wrong.
Well, okay. Well,
and so now you just have to let him go until 18, and then you can get in touch with them again, and hopefully you've set your life up right, and you've lived right, and you're someone to look up to.
Well, you said, yeah, we was wrong, maybe when we had when the kids, but if I take it to the courts, that don't mean that the courts enforced the wrongness. Two wrongs don't make no right.
I know.
If
you're not going to win the battle, why even bother?
Well, you ain't gonna win because you beta rhinos, and you want to give up on the fight, a fight that you ain't.
But we're talking about the fathers in the courts.
That's what we're talking about.
I know, but this is a different situation from the rhinos.
Well, no,
they're fighting, but they're playing, and they're just losing. They're just losing, and they're causing the people to donate money to them. And this is money poured down the drain because they're not fighting to win. Same thing, honestly, with you guys.
Okay,
you guys aren't fighting to win.
Well, check this out. Okay, so what are you saying about the police that did that busted up that big child trafficking ring up here in Ohio? It was just 93 people got busted up in that. So you saying that Well, even with them doing that, a lot of that reason why the child trafficking ring is happening is because there ain't a dad in the house.
I know.
You see what I'm saying?
Yep.
So the police, even the police are fighting a backwards battle.
Yeah.
Because it's really the courts that are participating in the child trafficking rings by removing the fathers.
Good point.
And extorting the men for money. You see what I'm saying? So
it, I saw MGTOW Misfit talking about that stuff. He was a little beside himself. And the Fallen State. You watched the Fallen State interview this past weekend?
No, sir, I missed it.
Oh, check it out if you, when you get a chance.
Yeah.
He interviewed a female lawyer who's on the side of the men, kind of.
She a beta. I seen it. She's a beta.
Okay.
Yeah, she's a beta. she's a liberal rhino. And
yeah.
That's something I'm glad.
I don't know if she's a rhino.
Yeah.
I don't even know if she pretends to be a Republican, but.
No,
yeah,
I don't think she said she was, but I listened to what she's saying.
Interesting info, though.
I listened to what she's saying, and I get tired of that. You got a lot of people that act like they are,
right?
Or they straddle the fence, and I'm able to peep that. You can act like you for men, act like you for men all day, but I see what it is. You wanna pity pat and act like you wanna put a band-aid on the situation and act like you really for what's right. But we know what's going on. You want your cake and your ice cream too.
All right.
I'm coming to the Congress to ask them, the betas and the alpha Republicans, that y'all need to figure that out. And I appreciate it. And I would be very thankful, just like a lot of these other American dads would be very thankful, if you can start getting stuff together and pass a law to make sure that you keeping kids. If they ain't in the house, you need to make sure that their kid, the dads, biological dads, are somewhere participating in their life, whether they want to or not. It's time to quit trying to pass over responsibility for the men and start making sure you holding them accountable for them raising their kids, and stop trying to traffic kids and let females run to other states with other men's kids.
Yeah.
God bless you.
It's ridiculous.
In the show.
I appreciate it, Art.
Yes, sir.
All right, man. Take care.
You too, buddy.
All right. Yeah, he's right. When you look at, for example, this story with Derek Chauvin having to subdue a 14-year-old young man, after the mother called the cops on him, and presumably his sister, I don't know, another daughter. Ridiculous. Out-of-control families, which is what the RINOs support, and the Democrats. He is right about that. And I don't know if it's wrong to do it, it just seems ill-advised. But anyway, that's that. I got a super chat from some little ethnic child on streamlabs.com/TheHakeReport. I heard a former adult film star is also considering a run for California governor. Really? Did you hear that? Some adult film star? Meaning pornography. That's what that means. Shameful. It's a big mess. I covered a little bit of details about some other guy who was running for governor, a Democrat. I think he's Indian. He was like this big tech guy, this tech person, you know, from Silicon Valley. Maybe originally from India or somewhere. But this guy, he looks like he would play reasonable, but we have like all bad choices. All bad choices. It reminds me of back in the year 2000, maybe 3 or so, or 2002. I forget when it was, but here in California. And I will get to Howard in North Carolina next. He wants to comment on the fear of standing up. But we ousted, we recalled, who was it? Gray Davis, some Democrat, right? And I don't even remember exactly why we recalled him. But we got to elect somebody in his place. And we had some Democrat, some Republican who was like a goody-two-shoes type of Republican, but maybe kind of weak. And then we had Arnold Schwarzenegger, who was running as a Republican. And yeah, we all knew that Arnold Schwarzenegger was a Republican. But he was more of a fiscally conservative guy. Socially liberal, fiscally conservative. And yes, I voted for him. Maybe twice, I don't know. And he did nothing. Really. He did nothing. What a shame. Anomaly should run. That'd be interesting. Would he win? Would he? I don't know. He might do okay. But yeah, I voted for that guy. He didn't really enforce the immigration. I mean, what can you California guy do with regard to the immigration thing? It's ridiculous. So we had Arnold, and then we had Jerry Brown, the son. His father was governor years before that, decades before that. Jerry Brown. Jerry Brown all old, and he didn't build up the reservoirs, so we have like this water, a drought mess. And now we have this beta governor with the beta baby. Newsom. Gavin Newsom. And Gavin Newsom is getting recalled, and now we have a bunch of lame people. Such a shame. But maybe we can take California back. Maybe. Yeah, people want Candace Owens to run for president. I heard people saying, oh, we want Kristi Noem for president. You know, the skinny female governor of North Dakota. No, is it South Dakota? One of those Dakotas. Shout out to the Dakotas. South Dakota. No thanks. No thanks. But thank you for the tip, some little ethnic child. What a shame. Okay. So, I want to talk about, speaking of these rhinos, you know how the first 100 days is supposed to be a big deal, right? Of the president. I remember I went to the top of the notch in Mount Baldy to meet with the people to celebrate Trump's first 100 days. Bunch of people were up there. Brittany Pettibone, Based Stickman, Baked Alaska, whole bunch of people. And it was cool. But now it's Biden's first 100 days, and he's done a lot of damage, hasn't he? He's gotten rid of the building of the wall. He has pretended that racism is this real thing and a big problem that we need to fix. He has talked about, we will embrace reparations for blacks, and we will reintroduce the 1619 Project and get rid of this racist, revisionist 1776 commission that President Trump did to counteract the revisionist history, the communist revisionist history. Now you have typical people thinking that America was based grift, man. Dang. I know those people. How things change, isn't it? Things change quite a bit. Anyway. He did all kinds of damage, and he's spouting off about Georgia, Florida, and all that madness. Being an evil person. Basically, Obama Part 2. He brought back transgenders to the military, I believe. And his guy, one of his secretaries, heads of these departments, lame departments, communist far-left departments, enemies of America from within America, are reintroducing the gay pride flag around at embassies around the world. It's sick. Climate, getting back into the Paris Climate Accords, which is a phony thing that's not going to fix the environment. It's just a phony thing. Just enemies of America. That's his first 100 days. And who do they have to answer? The Republicans? Tim Scott. Tim Scott is a black rhino. Like JLP said today, we do not have a Republican Party. He's supposed to do the response because after Biden's first... It's really Biden-Harris, right? Biden-Harris administration's first 100 days, which is really the Obama administration. He's going to do his first address to Congress, and Senator Tim Scott, the only black Republican senator, I think, from South Carolina, a RINO. He worked with Trump, but he worked for evil things with Trump. He didn't work for good things. Tim Scott complained during the Black Lives Matter riots last time about being racially profiled and stopped however many dozen times or dozens of times by the Washington, D.C. police. Probably because he drives fast, is my guess. I don't know. But he's been stopped a bunch of times and he's complaining about racial profiling. And he's doing all this stuff against the cops, pretending that racism is this real thing, that he's is a problem. And he called Trump's stuff racist. When Trump said that the people need to go back, the Democrat congresswomen of color need to go back. Lines are full, guys. Hang tight. He was like, oh, he needs to take that back. That was racially charged. Something like that. And Trump said something about, he was like, when he was forced to condemn white supremacy for the umpteen zillionth time. And Trump said, Proud Boys, because Biden is all, Proud Boys, you have to convict. Trump is like, who? Name them. I'll condemn it. And then Biden's all, Proud Boys. Give me a break, Proud Boys. They're such harmless, decent guys for the most part. And the ones who can commit harm are only harming Antifa. Let's be honest. And Antifa are evil. Don't even belong in America. But anyways, he's all, Proud Boys, stand back and stand by. And then Tim Scott is saying, I think he misspoke. And if he didn't fix it, maybe he didn't misspeak. Tim Scott, a backstabber of America. Shameful. All blacks are entertaining except Tim Scott. He's not entertaining. He's not even entertaining. That's how boring of a phony politician he is. And he's going to give the response to sleazy Joe Biden. At least Joe Biden is somewhat entertaining. He is. Let's be honest. Evil, but entertaining. Am I right? Dead. Come on, man. Get a life. What a shame. Anyway, they like losing. Anyway, kind of like the fathers in these courts. So I'm going to touch on this Armenian genocide thing. I'm very leery about it. It feels like these Syrians and these Armenians and all these people are getting all into their false identity and victimhood. And it's not a good situation. Is it me or are Armenians mostly Democrats? I'm going to get to that. If you're Armenian, you can call in, but the lines are full right now. Let me get to Howard in North Carolina. Wants to comment on this fear of standing up. What's up, Howard? It's good to hear from you.
I'm doing fine, James. How about you?
Doing fine as well. Thank you.
About like Jesse says, standing up with no fear.
Yeah.
Like I say, you need to pick your battles and don't stand up for your ego and your 15 minutes of fame.
Yeah.
If you stand up with the power of God behind you, you'd be a lot more effective.
Very true.
And don't have no fear and pick your battles. Don't just jump in there and start hollering and screaming like they do.
Right.
Back calmly.
Yeah. And, you brought up standing up for ego. I remember when I was first coming to Jesse Lee Peterson's stuff.
Yeah. And,
well, actually, it was 5 years in, actually. He said about women vote. He talked about women voting. And yeah. I remember The View covered it, and he got all kinds of backlash, and he stood his ground on it. I was so happy and excited. But the temptation was there, I remember, to even I wasn't working for Jesse at this point. I was a volunteer for the church with Jesse Lee Peterson at that time, Sunday services. And I remember wanting that attention to keep going and him to pull this or that maneuver to keep it going. But no, you don't try to manipulate reality or God or what happens. You just stand your ground, do what's right. And if the attention comes, that's great. If it doesn't come, that's great, too.
Let God guide you.
Right. There's a lot of preachers, I think, who are making a grandstanding about this not caving to the COVID shutdowns, and they're getting all this negative attention on them that maybe they don't need to be bringing on themselves, but it's an ego stand, maybe. I'm just bringing up the suggestion. It's just something to watch yourself with, no matter what you're doing.
I even caught myself. Am I doing this for my ego to get my 15 minutes of fame?
Yeah.
Or am I really doing this because I believe what I believe and God's really telling me to do it? And now I check myself.
Nice. That's cool.
You need to check yourself, people, before you just go off half.
Yeah.
Well, if I could say that word, but you know what I mean.
Go off half-cocked?
Yeah, half-cocked.
That's like a gun. It doesn't mean anything other than bad. That's funny.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure, right? When a gun is half-cocked.
Family-friendly show. I don't want to say nothing.
I know.
Like I did say one word one time, and I
that's funny.
Just slipped out.
I've traumatized you guys.
Yeah, but you're right.
You're like one of the best behaved callers, and you're concerned about it. That's funny.
And did you hear about what's going on in Elizabeth?
I did a little bit.
Carolina. Now it's coming here.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, it's everywhere, but
is that near where you are?
No, that's out towards the coast.
Elizabeth City.
I've never even heard of that county. I said, what? Park, such kind of funny name of the county, you know.
I don't know. Yeah.
I've heard of Elizabeth City, but I've never heard of the county that it's in.
Okay.
All the counties.
Yeah.
And they're having the Black Lives Matter rally down there and all that.
They've declared a state of emergency in Elizabeth City, North Carolina, ahead of the release of a body cam video of a cop apparently shooting some blah, 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 blah junior.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
42-year-old guy.
Yeah, and in Hickory, it's probably 10, 15 miles from here. I grew up in Hickory, you know, and I live in Claremont now.
Nice.
I don't know if you've heard of Hickory.
I feel like I might have heard of it, but I'm familiar with the wood. Hickory wood.
And Hickory wood.
Hickory tree. Very hard stuff.
And on the streets named Tate Boulevard, and it showed a car pulling out. I know where I used to ride Tate Boulevard to work. And another car came by and shot, and they shot a 7-year-old black boy.
Wow.
And the one that done it was a black guy, wasn't it? I'm talking to my wife.
Of course.
They caught the guy that done it. It was a black guy.
Wow.
And you don't see the race hustlers. They'll be down there in Elizabeth City now. I guarantee you that. But you won't hear nothing. 5 seconds of that little black boy getting shot in his car.
Wow. A candlelight vigil will be held tonight for the 7-year-old killed in the shooting while riding in the car with his mother.
Yes. That's hitting close to home, I don't know. That's real close to me.
Wow. With his mom and brothers, he was riding in his car. Mother and brothers. Interesting. Crazy. It's hard to keep up with all this stuff. A 23-year-old male been charged with first-degree murder.
Yes.
Of that Hickory boy. Douglas Mason Wilson of Claremont.
Claremont, that's where I live.
Yeah.
I don't see.
Wild.
Well, in the outskirts of Claremont, you know. It's just a little small town, you know.
Yeah.
Probably 10,000 people at the most, maybe.
Yeah, but this guy looks like a wild guy.
There's some rough characters around here, too. I just don't associate with them and don't really know who they are, but I know they're there.
They think the mother told police she thinks it was road rage, but the detectives are still looking into it.
I was wondering if it was one of her ex-boyfriends, ex-husband, or something about drugs.
Who knows?
Never said nothing about that. They said it could be road rage, like you said.
She said that she turned on her blinker and accidentally cut off the other vehicle. Women driving.
Wow.
Be careful, ladies.
Shoot a kid just because you get cut off.
Well, I don't know if he meant to shoot the kid. He just shot into the car, but whatever. Ridiculous. 8-month-old girl was hit in the lung by a stray bullet the night before.
Yeah.
Terrible. This is the Charlotte area, huh?
No, that's Hickory.
Oh, that was the Charlotte area, huh?
Hickory area.
Okay.
That happened. That was in Hickory.
Not far from Charlotte, North Carolina?
That's 50 miles.
Okay. That's
quite close.
Yeah.
It's about an hour drive to Charlotte, 45 if you go 80 or 85 like you're about. If you don't go with the traffic, you'll get run over.
Cute little black kid.
Yeah. That's a mess.
Yeah. What a shame. Well, I appreciate it, Howard.
Did you hear about one more thing, if you got time and all? And then,
yeah, real quick.
On Francis and Friends. That's where I first, you know who Francis
is? Yeah. Yeah, Jesse Lee Peterson has appeared on that show like multiple times, three, four times.
That's how I got introduced to Jesse.
Oh, cool. Francis and Friends. That's, so that's Francis is, what's her last name?
Swaggart. That's Jimmy
Swaggart. Jimmy Swaggart and his wife, Francis. Yeah.
And she was reading something she got off the internet. I'm not sure she might have told about what the government is doing, turning to send the communists. They want the, you know, house prices are real high now.
Oh, yeah.
Real low. Said that I've already bought up $20 billion worth of mortgages the government has.
Wow. But
they don't want you to own anything. They want to own everything. Like Jesse, they say owning your own land is
right.
Most free thing you can have.
Man.
They buy everything. They want to own everything, what the government is doing right now.
Yeah.
They want to own all the businesses, all the land, all the houses, and you pay them to live there just like a communist country.
Yep.
And you can see it, and people don't see it.
Yeah.
It's right in front of them. Okay, it's good to talk to you, James.
Good to hear from you, Howard. Appreciate that tip. Thank you. Take care.
Yeah, people stand up.
Yeah. Thanks again. Take care.
No fear, picky battles, and you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, Howard. Appreciate you. Yeah, Frances Swaggart. She had Jesse Lee Peterson on at least three, maybe four, maybe more than that times. And that's smart, tough lady. Her husband is Jimmy Swaggart. Jimmy Swaggart. The great Jimmy Swaggart, I think. I just put a couple of screenshots in the folder. Before I go to break, guys, I'm going to get to Rick from Maine after this break, guys. But I have a couple of screenshots. They're called screenshot. Of this 17-year-old boy shot and killed in Hickory, North Carolina. And the suspect who was arrested, Douglas Mason Wilson. Light-skinned black guy. Looks like he might smoke pot, I don't know. But he wasn't chill when he did that. Allegedly. She said that she didn't even hear the gunshot. She just saw the muzzle flash. Terrible, huh? Do you see the stuff in there? Here's the little kid and the, man. Who, And I don't know what this woman did. Hey, look at the boy. I mean, it has a play button in front of it, but you get the picture. Cute little boy. Got himself killed, but didn't even get himself killed. He was just riding in the back of his mother's car. And maybe she was driving crazy. I don't know. And then the male fired into the vehicle, allegedly. Terrible. Anyway, guys, hopefully this thing is fixed for my end, this audio feed. I think that Bill and Chris were able to do it. So this is, let's do the other song. Just Fools? This song is by Ghoti Hook. Oh no, Middle Ground. This is Ghoti Hook, This Should Work, Christian band from 1997. I liked it when I was a sophomore, junior, and to this day. Punk rock, cover your ears. But it's like pop punk, so it's like easy to listen to. Oh man, it's echoing still. To this day thing. Let's do To This Day one more time. JB had to cray, he make you one cuss. Oh man. Oh, it's terrible. One more thing. Poor little guy. Yeah, I agree, Skyway. Afro man bun. Bait! Says Eric. Yeah, that's true. Skip. Skip. Censor yourself. Terrible. Based AF. Based America First. Gave a super chat and said, Hake is smarter than MIT experts. Took them over a year to determine that masks and social distancing don't work. And virtually impossible to catch the coof while outside. And yet, you have people wearing their masks outside, jogging by themselves. I don't judge them, but it does look silly, and it is a shame, and sometimes people can't breathe. I heard that there was a girl, a sprinter girl, you know, they let women participate in women's or girls' sports, young ladies participate in girls' sports in high school. And some girl I heard collapsed after her sprint race because she was forced to wear a mask outside. What a shame. Ridiculous. MIT is, what, Massachusetts Institute of Technology or something like that? It's one of those smart schools. There's, or something. A source for the previous super chat by some little ethnic child shares an ex porn star, Mary Carey, reportedly running for California governor. Los Angeles billboard model, drives a pink Corvette. And she, or maybe two. Is that two different people? A former so-called adult actress whose real name is Mary Cook said she has big plans for California. No thanks. It's time for someone with a new attitude from outside the mainstream of politics to lead. The New York Post describes her as a... Never mind. I'll skip that description. New York Post can get kind of sleazy, a la Daily Mail. You think it's fixed now?
I think it's fixed.
Okay.
Amazing!
Nice! So, it's a former VH1 reality TV star, actually, too. Retired from the pornography business. Launched a campaign website featuring merchandise. Yeah, I think Bruce Jenner is selling Caitlyn because that's his taken name. Am I dead naming Bruce? Because spiritually he's dead and I'm calling him by his former real identity? Whatever. Anyway, guys, enjoy. This is Middle Ground by Ghoti Hook from the album Banana Man, which makes it sound ridiculous. Half the songs were silly, half of them are serious. I picked a serious one because I prefer those. Enjoy this from 1997, Tooth and Nail Band. I'll be right back in a couple of minutes here.
Da 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 da. Jericho. Yes. He helped Daniel get out the lion's den.
And we're back, guys. Wow, I drove away many of my callers. I was about to get to Rick from Maine. But that was Ghoti Hook. Says, Hake in the pit, punk rock. Oh, my Lord. My dogs are going crazy again. They're running around in circles and running into the walls. They got my wheelchair again, says Skip McBurney. Ghoti is a phonetic spelling for fish. It's supposed to be fish hook. One of their dads came up with it because they're a Christian band. Fish hook. It's like fishers of men. Ghoti, G-H, the G-H is the F, makes the F sound in the word enough, like Ghoti, G-H, G-H-O-T-I, right? And the O, like in women, sounds like the I in fish, okay? And then the T-I is the sh sound, like in nation, N-A-T-I-O-N. It's corny. It was somebody's probably boomer dad came up with it. And these dumb Christian punk kids went with it. And so they were stuck with the name Ghoti Hook for their career, which lasted from, like, maybe early 90s through 03 or something like that.
What the?
It's cheesy, but I like it. I mean, I like the group. One of my favorites, actually. Sounds like Deftones, said Willie Palomino. I'm not too familiar. I was very sheltered, but I've heard good things. My toes are tapping, drums are great, vocals are meh, is what people are saying. Dirk Diggler says, much better than usual, thank you. Too fast, says Jay. I'm behind. The music ain't bad, the vocals are meh, says Colin Barrett. Yeah. Anyway, guys, I was gonna get to Rick in Maine, but he could not hang on. That's okay, Rick. Appreciate you, man. Let me get to Kevin in Chicago, Illinois. He wants to comment on this UFC fight. He has a tip about this UFC fight. There was a UFC fight over the weekend, I heard. And he says that a communist fighter lost. What? Kevin in Chicago, how are you?
Hey, how y'all doing? This is Billy from Texarkana. How y'all doing?
Doing well. Did you say your name is Billy from Texarkana?
Yes, sir.
Wow, I'm all confused because the name says Kevin from Chicago, Illinois.
Oh, man, y'all done got me mixed up. I'm going to tell y'all what. Yep, the communist fighter from China, the Chi-Com.
Uh-huh.
She lost to the Lithuanian American, Rose Namajunas.
A woman?
Rose, yep. Before they came out to fight, Rose came out, she's saying, I got nothing against her personally, but what she represents, she's a communist. Better dead than red, and you should have seen the reactions to these comments. Oh my gosh, we got no place for that, this and that.
Wow.
Back in the day, Max Schmeling versus Max Bear, this is all they were talking about. It was the Nazi. Oh, Schmeling the Nazi is going against a Jewish American. It's the Nazi. They all loved it. People were eating it up.
Yeah.
But now when Rose comes out here, she said it's nothing personal, but she's a communist, and she represents communism. My family from Lithuania had to deal with the communists. And, you know, I'm Polish-American. The Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, we're hip and hip in regards to that. We know all about the oppression.
Right.
And so to see the media come down on her for those comments, it's just they're communist sympathizers.
Yeah.
That's what it comes down to. We got a bunch of communist sympathizers. And what's the dude that he tried to warn us with the Red Scare back in the day? McCarthy.
Yeah.
He was spot on. And then what'd they do? They made him out to be a nut.
Right.
But he was spot on. These people, they're a bunch of, maybe it went a little bit overboard, but his premise was correct. The communists have infiltrated every facet of our lives, media, law, court, everything you could think of. So shout out to Rose Namajunas, the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth wins again. The communists took a kick to the face, knockout. What y'all mean, boy? Woo!
That's funny. Yeah, well, and it was a girl fight. What the heck? That's strange.
Hey,
interesting, man. So your name is Billy, right?
There.
Billy from Texarkana. And where is Texarkana again?
Texarkana, Arkansas, Bubba, how y'all doing?
Doing well. You've called in before, haven't you, or no? Is this your first time?
Yes.
Okay. Well, thank you for the update. That's cool. Right on to the anti-communists. You know,
and that's what I love about the UFC. People like to hate on sports, you know, it's a distraction, this and that. But with Dana White, he's a Republican. He backed Donald Trump, and he was the first one to call out this this COVID hysteria. He brought it back. They filled the stadium up, and everybody was throwing it. Oh, it's super spreader, this and that.
Yeah.
But he doesn't bend the knee. He's a real alpha. He doesn't take no crap because all the media like to come down on him. Always, he's so irresponsible, this and that.
Right.
But he stands up to the communist left.
That's,
shout out to Dana White.
Yeah.
Shout out to the
that's
UFC.
Cool. Right on. And you know what? They do their precautions. They're not trying to be irresponsible and reckless. They're like trying to keep people trying to be safe about it and smart about it. From what I've understood,
they test everybody.
Yeah,
they spend hundreds of thousands of dollars test the cornermen,
yep,
the fighters, the people coming in. You take all the precautions, but it doesn't matter because these people, they want to suck the fun out of everything.
Yeah,
they want everybody to be miserable.
Yes,
like them behind a keyboard.
Great point.
But I'll leave you to it. Take it easy, Bubba.
All right, you too, Billy. Take care. Very nice. You know, it's interesting. These former communist countries, they come out with some of the more sensible people, interestingly. They're like anesthetized, is a word that I heard. I don't know if that's the right word, probably. Probably not the right word. Somebody said this. Maybe somebody said it on a super chat on Vox Day's stream, of all places. I just remember, these people coming from these communist countries, or these communist, former communist countries in general, are much more, dare I say, based than the capitalist countries, so-called capitalist countries, which are sliding. Basically, they're communist already. Dana White may not be a Christian, but he's a decent guy, says JJ Money. Interesting. Yeah, you know, and, and, you know who else seems like he's doing all right? I don't know, but he seems like he's doing all right. And he may be kind of weak in, at times. This governor of Florida, Ron DeSantis. And I like the fact that over at CPAC, however many weeks ago, or months ago, he, won the straw poll, second to Trump, of course. Ukraine is still a S blank hole. Yeah. I guess. They're getting kissed up to by Biden, I hear. But I don't know. You know, I was thinking about how that rock star, Ted Nugent, how he allegedly he performed at some anti-COVID shutdown, like a grocery store or something. He performed somewhere. 72-year-old man. You guys are ripping on Vox Day. Leave him alone. He's very entertaining if you're not low IQ. No, I'm playing around with you guys. And supposedly, like, after Ted Nugent performed at this event, he caught the COVID thing, and he said he almost died and all that stuff after he'd said that it's a scam. It is a scam. And it also is deadly for a unhealthy 72-year-old, possibly. Right? But it's still a scam, but it's still something not to mess around with and just be reckless and all cocky about. Right? Because then you're like testing God rather than using your God-given common sense and being a, as Trump was called, a germaphobe, a, what is that thing that they call something, EAC? Not mitochondriac. I forget what it was. Hypochondriac? No, not a hypochondriac, though, either. It's more like a, I forget what it is, something phobe. Basically, somebody sneezes or coughs in the room, he's like, can you do that outside? He doesn't like that. Reminds me of a friend of mine who, anytime somebody sneezes, even if it's across the restaurant, he like covers up his nose and mouth. He's like, oh! He like overreact anytime you sneeze. Anyway, arachnophobia? Asks Jib Jeff. No, man. The mitochondria, germaphobe. Yeah, germaphobe, but there was something else. Mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cells, says Nick. I remember that vaguely from 7th grade or 8th grade. I had a male teacher, and he got under attack. Obsessive compulsive, says Roger that. That's hypochondriac, hey? Okay, but I read something about it in the United States of Trump, that Trump was did not like any germs. Some guy touched his mask when he delivered his food, and so he didn't even eat the meal. Right on, President Trump. King! Homophobiac? Asks Paul Robertson. Forget that. Anyway, thank you to the Super Chat supporters, Based America First and Some Little Ethnic Child. That is wild. But I just wonder if that guy who got himself sick, you know, I'm glad that Ted Nugent, it seems like he's recovering, right, Ted Nugent? But he may have been a little reckless about it. And sometimes these guys are reckless, especially if they're, like, fat. And then they die and stuff. Don't mess around like that. Just because it is a scam doesn't mean you don't be wise at the same time. Oh, Rick from Maine came back. Let me get to Rick. Rick from Maine, how are you doing?
Oh, we're doing just fine, my brother. I had to step into the building there. I was in a weak signal area to start with.
Okay.
So I stepped into the building and killed the signal, period.
Yep.
yeah. I sent a very interesting article to Nick. He's going to go through it.
Nice.
But sit down when you read that thing.
Okay.
It's who, what, when, where, and why of the seed problem that we have.
Of the what problem?
The seed. COVID problem.
Oh.
I didn't want to say it.
Oh, okay. The China / commie virus.
Yes. Gavin Nuisance? Yeah. That's what we call him.
Yeah.
You know,
that's a good name. You got him.
I got a governor. Yeah. I got a governor very close to that same caliber up here in this state, and definitely do not like her either.
Yeah.
But what you've got there, if you stop and think about it, James, you've got a perfect example of socialism in that state.
True.
Because that's exactly what socialism is. It takes from one person illegally or however they want to call it and gives to another one that does not earn it.
Yeah, true.
So when you've got that combination, socialism. So when people say, well, socialism is good, socialism is this, that, and the other thing, you better recognize what socialism is, because if you adopt it into your state, which California has.
Yeah. Globalist socialism, too.
Yep.
Globalist. They're a sanctuary
yep.
state
That's
for
right.
everything evil. It's ridiculous.
That's right. It's too bad, but that's the way it is.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I don't like what's coming down the pike. People that I talk to, people that I listen to out here, they don't like it, and it's not going to be a good thing.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just hoping that this love scenario with Biden and his crew, the people that are in those seats, realize what they're doing, because they're going to destroy this country completely.
Yeah.
And they've already got a pretty good start at it.
Well, we'll see what happens.
Yep.
I appreciate
Take
your
care,
call,
brother.
Man. You too.
All right. All right, man.
All right. I'm going to get to Tony in California next. He is a fan favorite. Am I right? Except that some people just cannot stand him. Hang on, Tony. I will get to you. I almost missed some super chats. Shout out to Justice S. With the super chat says, bonus dears all. And that is Earl for buenos dias, which is Spanish for good mornings. Good morning. James, how funny. I stand corrected. And she's referring to a prior super chat. It says rewired in chat. And that's a reference to a fellow supporter and super chatter and YouTube viewer named Sixto Rewired. And then he super chats as Sixto Rewhited. Genius. My apologies, but my point was passing on an entomology awareness reminder, especially in times like these. And entomology is a reference to, entomology is like the study of words, right? Something like that? Entomology? Yeah. In which she kind of broke down the name Derek Michael Chauvin. Derek being hangman, spelled a certain way, right? Michael being like sent from God or something like that. And Chauvin is like chauvinist. We are Western chauvinists. We will not apologize for the Western world, is one of the Proud Boys sayings or something that you have to say. Something along those lines, right? Chauvinist. Male chauvinist. Ah, they think they're better than the women. But it's so funny because it's used by women who think they're better than the men. Kind of like how blacks think the whites are racist when the blacks are the ones who are misjudging the whites. Interesting. Yeah, especially in times of like these, be aware of this entomology. And yeah, and they totally manipulate language, period. Keep up the good doer work, Justice S goes on. I appreciate and thank you all, Bond people. Right on behalf of all Bond, thank you, Justice S. Appreciate you. Nice. Sixto Rewhited, speaking of the devil, or the man, Sixto Rewhited gave a super chat on streamlabs.com/TheHakeReport and said, what's with all these racism believers acting like blacks are going extinct and the poachers are cops? Top liar Joe Obama. Meaning Joe Obama from Arizona. I call him Joe Obama, right? Obama from Arizona. Joe from Phoenix, right? Not to be confused with Joe Obama Biden. Sleazy Joe. But Joe Obama from Arizona says only 0.015% of blacks are violent criminals, yet they make up the majority of the general population in prison. 13/51 is not a myth. 13% commit 51% of the murders, according to some studies. In the nation, year after year after year, I think, is what it is. Yeah, fair enough. Interesting. Peter from Periscope with a super chat. I missed these because they were like a day ago. I'm like, a day ago, that seems old. But a day ago, I did not have a show, so I've got to read these. Peter from Periscope, you can give super chats even when I'm off air through this Streamlabs thing. Interesting, huh? Streamlabs.com/TheHakeReport. Peter from Periscope says, from the looks of it, you seem to frequent Big Bear every weekend. No, not quite, but I just went, sometimes I get on a kick. And so I went like multiple weeks in a row. When are you going to get some property there? Seems like a nice small town. Yeah, it is a nice small town. I don't know. I wonder how much it is. I was looking into properties. And I had to look way out in San Bernardino. Riverside area. And this was a year ago, right? More than a year ago. To find anything under like 400,000. Oh, crazy. It's a mess. But yeah, I think that Big Bear is probably more popular today than ever because, or than in years, because of the communist shutdowns, many stuff is closed. So you try to go to this place or that place for a vacation, closed. So weekend after weekend, the Big Bear place is pretty happening, pretty busy. No Name Pizza, which I like to frequent. Dark Side of the Bear, what I heard was talking bad about No Name Pizza, calling it cardboard. Excuse me. You probably tasted it 16 years ago when they first started. They have it down. But No Name Pizza said that last year was their... They're not necessarily for these shutdowns, but they said last year was their best year because people were coming up. You call it 4 o'clock, they close at what, 6, 7, 8, 9? You call it 4 o'clock, they're not taking any more orders because they're just slammed. Crazy, huh? What is Big Bear? Big Bear is a city. There is a, I think it's a big man-made lake there, Big Bear Lake, but it's man-made. And it's up in the mountains near Lake Arrowhead and other places. It's the mountains. People go skiing there. Anyway. Yeah, thank you, Peter from Periscope. Yeah, maybe one day. Hake, I'm from Elizabeth City, says BB42 with a super chat on streamlabs.com/TheHakeReport. Elizabeth City, North Carolina, that's where they're doing an emergency thing. I can try and call in tomorrow. Small Coast Guard town. Majority black. A lot of drugs. Wow. Yeah, I was looking at this Elizabeth town. I think I was looking at this Elizabeth town. No, I wasn't. I think I was looking at someplace else. Because there was another shooting that it looked ghetto where a shooting took place. And by ghetto, I mean looked like projects. You know those beautiful government buildings? They build the projects, and it looks all beautiful. Grass. But it's basically this huge subsidized apartment building where ghetto people do stuff that is unsavory. It's a big mess. It's crazy. So before I get to Tony, we're at the bottom of the hour here. Connor's a first-time caller from New Hampshire. He's talking about fighting for custody. In his case, he says it's worth it. Cool. I'll get to you, man. Hang tight. I want to talk briefly about this Joe Biden acknowledging the Armenian Genocide over 100 years later. To me, what's the point anymore? But I know that there are Armenians, even conservative guys, decent guys, friends of mine, friends of Bond, who've wanted this thing to be acknowledged as a genocide. Armenian Christians were mass killed, according to the story, in 1915, starting in April 24th, by the Turks, the Young Turks. Was it the Young Turks in the Ottoman Empire, according to the story, right? And 1.5 million Armenian Christians killed, according to the Armenians. The Turks, who were the perpetrators 100, however many years ago, 105, 106 years ago, they say, oh, the numbers are inflated. Sound familiar? Some people say the numbers are inflated of this or that genocide, right? And maybe so, who knows, right? Seems like the people, the survivors, or the people who are on behalf of the victims often try to play up these things, right? Play up how bad this or that was. Even to this day, they're talking about, oh, George Floyd was murdered. No, that's not murder. But they're calling it that. If legally they were allowed to do that, that's a messed up law. I'll tell you that much. At the turn of the 20th century, the Ottoman Empire was crumbling. Many distrusted the loyalty, right, of Christian Armenians in the East. And this is another reason why this immigration thing is not a good thing, because it feeds suspicion amongst different peoples. Even the Armenians here, they come here and then they're flying all these Armenian flags. And the same thing with the, a week ago, there were some, like, this portion of Ethiopia that's been subjected to, like, allegedly genocide, too. Even right now. They were flying flags. I forget where it was. I asked about it on Twitter. In Ethiopia. Crazy stuff going on around the world and to this day. But they're recognizing stuff from 100 years ago, right? Many of the Armenians were deported to Syria and other places. countless dying in the trek. They call it the first genocide of the 20th century. Joe Biden on Saturday, he marked the Armenian Genocide Remembrance Day by officially declaring the mass killings a genocide. Obama had promised this same thing to the Armenians before he was elected, and then he didn't do it. For 8 years, he didn't do it. I don't know if Trump ever made such a promise. He called it a mass... What did Trump call it? His administration, right? He called it one of the worst mass atrocities of the 20th century. But he didn't use the word genocide. See, these phony intellectuals play these word games. Oh, you have to call it a genocide. And people are talking about what's going on in South Africa. They're calling that a genocide. And then some people are saying, no, it's not a genocide yet. How about is wrong what's happening? Racism is worse than murder to these people. Racism. There's a lot of mass killings of Christians that took place in the 20th century, but they don't really acknowledge that. Anyway, Turkey's mad. They pulled their ambassador, I think, something like that, condemning Biden's thing, calling his terminology, calling it outrageous. And honestly, I think that it's silly. I think that Biden is roping in more victim groups, because there's a lot of Armenians, at least here in L.A., Glendale, and they tend to be like Democrats, it seems like. Some of them were on the board of the Glendale City Council that got rid of their Glendale gun show. There used to be a gun show. It was awesome. No problems ever associated with it, to my knowledge. Gun shows, people well-behaved, and no, it doesn't really attract the riffraff that other things attract, right? But now he's roping them in, another victim group to play victim, over 100 years later. Seems sketchy to me. President Trump encouraged Armenians and Turks to acknowledge and reckon with their painful history. The Young Turks, remember the Young Turks with Cenk Uygur? And his co-host is an Armenian girl. Isn't Young Turks kind of like calling yourself the Nazi boys or something like that? Young Turks, weren't they the ones who went after the Armenians, I think? I could be wrong. I heard that it was an offensive name to the notion of the Armenians. Armenians didn't like that name. They felt that that's an offensive name. Anna Kasparian, yeah. Anytime it ends in I-A-N or Y-A-N, that's some type of Armenian or other, I hear. And so many of them are Democrats. And then they come here and they don't necessarily have loyalty to America sometimes. Oftentimes, usually. Does Hake know that April was Ginger Nerd Awareness Month? What? It's crazy. But I don't trust, obviously I don't trust Biden, and neither should you Armenians trust Joe Biden, if you're listening. I know I have some Armenian friends. Jib Jab asks with the super chat, if you could move anywhere in California, where would you buy some land? Huh. I don't know. I'll have to think about that one, Jib Jab. I do like Big Bear. I love LA. I like SoCal. I don't know. I grew up in Temple City. That was nice. Temple City, El Monte. But I mean, I don't know. It's a TYT is satire. No way those people really believe half this stuff they talk about, says Jim Eagle. I suppose it's possible they do believe it all. Or they're just evil. They love lies. When you are evil, or when you are angry, you just believe anything. Let me get to Tony in California. Did I wrap up that Armenian thing? The Turks are a mess, but the Armenians are a mess too. They used to be communists too, by the way. And they shysters. It's a fact, Jack. No offense, Jack. Not Jack. Anyway, Tony in California, how are you doing? Tony. He's
hey.
Not. Oh, you were lucky. What's up?
You know, what's happening, man?
Nothing, man.
I see you playing that devil's music, bro. What's up with that? That used to did you do a lot of acid when you was younger?
I never did acid. I don't even know what it looks like or is.
Well, that music you playing is sound like for people that's on acid. You know?
Oh, really?
Or devil worship, you know?
You know about devil music?
Excuse me?
You know about devil music?
I don't know nothing about that, sir.
Oh, then how do you know that it sounds like devil music and acid music? Did you ever do drugs?
There were white folks used to do a lot of acid back there in the day. You
know, the only person I know who did acid was somebody who is not white.
Somebody that's not what?
White. I know one person who did acid.
Where do you think acid came from? White folks.
I know we invented everything, but you guys did it.
No, you didn't invent everything. That's a lie. That's another Christian lie right there.
This is Christian music. Ghoti Hook is Christian music.
Oh my God! Well, I'm glad I'm not a Christian.
Well, if you're a Christian, doesn't mean you have to listen to Ghoti Hook.
Come on, man! Stop all that laboring. Leave that laboring stuff alone. That's your human being. That's all you gotta do. Stop looking at people's color. Stop hating them because they look better than you, or they are bigger.
They look better. They look better. They're bigger and stronger.
That's right.
We invented the pyramids. We invented drugs. We invented religion. Everything.
You wasn't even around when the pyramids came.
I was there.
You can't even explain how they was built. So don't even go with that. Another lie.
They were built by the Israelites, the white Israelites.
Yeah, the white Israelite, really, you can't stand the sun 3 hours. You talking about white Israelite?
Oh, it goes on. You spelled it on. I heard the pharaohs were white.
Yeah, okay, in your dreams they were.
Except for the one who didn't release the white Israelites.
Yeah. That like they said, Jesus was lost in the city. Moses was lost in the city, right? And he was white too. Really? Wow. But the thing is,
he did interracially marry, I heard. He married a Ethiopian gal.
Okay.
Moses.
The thing is, I called because you see that California is finally doing the right thing by giving the land of Manhattan Beach, California, back to the black man that purchased it in 1912.
Dang.
1912.
To me, this is kind of like the Armenian Genocide thing. It's too little, too late.
No, it ain't never too late, bro.
Yeah, it is.
that one thing for sure.
Yeah, it's too late.
Because the Manhattan going to pay the family $750 million for back pay.
It'll be gone in a week.
Plus, give their land back to them.
You know what blacks invented?
Everything.
The hood. That's what Blazing Hog says. I disavow. I'm on your side.
That came from the government.
Well, I'm on the black side. I don't know about your side.
Okay, well, you know what I'm saying. Let's be human.
So a black man owns all of Manhattan Beach?
No, I didn't say that. I said he bought property.
Property.
Beachfront property.
Yeah.
Right.
So what's the story? Was it, not that I'm going to get the real story from you, but what's the story? Was it eminent domain?
Well, they took it from them because they didn't want black people on the beach. They said they didn't want blacks. All that racism.
That was prescient.
Before Jesse was born. Before he was born. Racism exists.
Per Nick, it was eminent domain.
Okay, eminent domain.
Yeah, they can take your land for public benefit.
Right.
But
so that's why they got to pay.
Like you guys go to the beach and
$750 million back to their family.
Could anyone in that family swim?
Of course they can swim. What are you talking about?
Because there was one black guy in my league for cross country. And it's a sad story.
But he was,
I'm serious. He was, no. He was the fastest guy.
Of course he was the fastest because he's black.
Right. But he was, but we trained him in super race guy because we bred him. But anyway,
y'all ran him off.
No, he died. His boat capsized. He was at a summer camp and he drowned. It's crazy.
How he drowned and he was the fastest swimmer?
Runner, fastest runner.
Oh, you said swimmer. Oh,
no, I meant runner for cross country.
Okay, I agree with
you. Yeah, so it's crazy.
But the thing is, sir, there's a lot of places right now are looking back in their history of their ancestors, and we are getting back the land that Jesse Lee Peterson saying that we are taking back. Yeah, we're taking it back because y'all stole
it's a specific family, Tony. It's not we.
No.
Yes. And that had nothing to do with racism. It was just eminent domain. It wasn't about this madness.
It was all about race. It was always about race.
You don't know us.
You know what, Dave?
Whoa.
And that's a problem. That's a major problem. Because y'all don't want to be known.
Oh, come on.
See?
Just drive your truck.
How many black friends you hang out with? Zero. How many black friends Chris hang out with? Zero. And Nick, zero.
And?
Y'all ran
because Joel, you guys don't make good friends.
Y'all ran the best thing y'all had on the show, Joel, away from
that. Whatever.
They're
I gotta go.
Y'all playing. Bam, 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 bam.
So do whites whose land got taken by eminent domain, do they get to get their land? Or do they lose the land that they bought rightfully?
What land did they lose to the government?
All over the place. It's happening in America, and it's happening in South Africa.
Well, it's happening in America because the wall went up that's falling down as we speak. Yeah, people are pissed behind that, building the wall without their permission.
Asmodor has a super cap for you on Trovo.
And I don't know nothing about all this Trovo, Asmodor.
Okay, well, it's a super chat. It's a super chat for you.
What did his mother name him? Well, I want to know what his mama name him. The Asmodor super chat.
If you're so interested, you could go on to Trovo. But I don't know if they really want you. But he asks, he asks, if Whitey is so bad, why does Tony insist on having access to them? Wouldn't Tony be happier in Africa?
You know one thing, Asmodor, Super Troll, whatever you want to call yourself. I was born here just like maybe you were. I don't know where you come from. But the thing
He's
is,
American.
I was born on this land, and I'm going to stay on this land, and I'm going to do what I'm supposed to do on this land.
All right. Well, nice talking with you. Thank you, Tony.
Mind your business and get you some black friends. Have a good day, y'all.
All right. Amazing advice. Let me get to Connor in New Hampshire, a first-time caller, wants to talk about this custody situation. I had a little disagreement earlier last hour with Art in Ohio, because Art is fighting for his son in the courts. I think his son, a child. In the courts against a vindictive mother, apparently. Wants to keep the child away from the father. So common. Connor, a first-time caller, what's up?
Hey, how's it going, Hank? It's a pleasure to talk to you.
Hey, going well. Thank you.
Hey, I just wanted to say that I don't disagree with Jesse, and nor do I disagree with Art, because I think in some cases, it's definitely, you got to pick your battles. It's definitely, in some cases, it's a real losing battle.
Yeah.
But for me, that's kind of what I thought at the beginning. I had my daughter's just about turned 3, and I had to go deal with the courts in Massachusetts, and they're notorious, the family courts in Massachusetts, for years for taking not the man's side, obviously. But
sounds right, yep. Massachusetts.
And I don't know if I just got lucky or if the Lord is just watching out for me, but I didn't pay very much for my lawyer. My parents helped me out just a little bit, but I didn't pay very much. I got a very cheap lawyer. But because I was straightening my life out and I realized how much damage I had caused, frankly, since my daughter's been born, I've really turned around a whole new leaf in my life. And I'm very happy to say that today me and her have a very strong relationship. I get her this week. I have her all week, but I get her every weekend. And most of the time, because of her mother, I'm getting her more than what even the court said I should get her for. And I don't know. I think it's just because I give it all up to the Lord. It really has nothing to do with me. He's changed the man I am today. But
nice.
You know what I mean? But if it wasn't for that initial like shame and grief, which is good, it's not a bad thing. You know,
right.
That I think all fathers feel at the beginning. If it really wasn't for that, I mean, and then the right direction towards Christ. I mean, I really don't think I'd be the man I am today.
Yeah.
So I speak for all men out there who are wondering if it's the right thing to do. Don't, Jesse's right. Don't sink a lot of money. Don't waste your time. If it's going to be, because for my case, it took less than, I don't know, less than 6 months from
cool.
the arraignment and all that stuff.
Yeah.
But now it's tough because of COVID. I understand a lot of court systems are closed. But, you know, I say just keep look towards God and you know, be still, like Jesse always says. And I think, you know, you'll find the answer. You'll know in your heart of hearts. But for me, it worked. And so I agree with Art. I think if you give up that battle quick, because it's not a one answer for everybody. But
right.
If you give up that battle immediately and you don't look to the Lord, then you know, you will lose if you don't ask for help from the Lord. That's all I gotta say, really.
Nice, man. Well, that's a good story. Your daughter, the birth of your daughter lit a fire under you or to turn your life around or what?
Yeah, yeah. I was my life was definitely unmanageable. I was an alcoholic and I was a bartender. I was living a life of a real simple life, real hedonistic lifestyle. But I got to say that I don't know what it was. And I think it's just, you know, the Lord's grace, really. Not, you know, no one's ever too far away from the grace to be saved. And I don't know, man, it's just, you know, just, I just turned to the Lord and hit my knees at that point. And so far, so good. So I just take it day by day and, you know, keep moving forward here.
Was it a divorce or out of wedlock thing or what?
I was totally out of wedlock.
Oh, okay.
And I knew what I was doing too. It wasn't an accident or nothing. It's, like the caller before on Jesse's, on the last hour of Jesse's show, he said he knew that he wasn't protecting himself, she wasn't protecting herself. It's kind of the same situation. And then, man, it's, I knew what I was getting myself in. I knew the consequences. I thought I was invincible, and I didn't think it could ever happen to me, kind of a thing.
Yeah. Interesting, you know? Man. Well, that's cool.
Too, keep up the music. It's been awesome. What a pleasure it is to hear all this music being played. And Chris is doing a great job.
Nice.
And I appreciate everything you guys do. You guys are doing a real service to all men across America.
Well, thank you, Connor. And Chris, thanks you as well. We're going to see you at the men's conference this summer?
Oh, man, I wish. I really wish. Maybe not this year.
Okay.
I'd love to make it down there, though, to meet you guys. I'm all the way on the other side
okay.
of the continent. But you know,
it's going to be down in Orlando, Florida, just so you know.
Florida, that's right.
It's still a ways from New Hampshire, but... If you can, you're welcome.
It's a little closer than California, that's for sure. Thank you.
Yeah.
I really do appreciate it, Hank. Keep up the good work, man.
Thank you, Connor. Good to hear from you. Take care.
All right, Amen. Take it easy.
All right. Yeah, that's why I don't really, I mean, to me, this is more Jesse's message to you guys. I'm no expert on this thing, but I don't really press Art on it that much because he knows his situation. But, all right, tell Tony X, Derek is your black homeboy, and stop calling with these weak hashtag black excellence stories. This is a message from Big Bump. SMH, shaking his head. That's true. These are weak. Weak, Tony. The man whose home was taken by the government... If he was alive, I would support, okay, give it back to him. I guess. Unless he was compensated. In some cases, they're compensated a little bit. Asmodor with the Trovo Supercap says, granted, Tony was born here, same as me. The difference is, I don't hate the country, says Asmodor. Or the people who built it. Nor its institutions. I love them. If I did, I would seek to leave rather than spend my life accusing and whining like a female, like Tony. Thank you, Asmodor. Great point. The Bruce family was compensated, according to NBC, says Nick, way back then. And now you have this so-called white woman, Janice Hahn, LA County supervisor, talking about Manhattan Beach is beautiful, by the way. Although it seems like it might be on its decline because homelessness spreading like crazy, crime is spreading like crazy. Watch your back, people. But this woman is talking like, oh, all of America should be seeking to right these wrongs and give me a break. She was one of the people who was trying to be pretending like she was trying to be reasonable with these communist shutdowns of the restaurants and outdoor dining and all that stuff. Well, she showed her true colors here. Kissing up. What a disgrace. Do we even have a male on the county board of supervisors anymore? I know we had Mark Ridley Thomas. Born Mark Thomas, and then he hyphenated his name when he got married. What a simp! He's black, too. Mark Ridley Thomas. What a shame. He's one of the guys that Jesse Lee Peterson yelled at. I think he might be the guy that Jesse was pointing at in that picture on the T-shirt that says, "You are a beta male!" I think he's pointing at him. That's when Mark Ridley Thomas betrayed L.A. and all Americans, including blacks, by kissing up to the illegals, by boycotting the Arizona for its law. Show us your papers, law. There goes the neighborhood, says Brandon M. Yeah, I know. What a mess. Let me get to Drew in Florida. He has a question. Drew, how are you doing?
I'm good. Doing well, James. How are you?
I'm doing fine, too. Thank you. Good to hear from you.
Yeah, you too. I wanted to ask you a question. Why don't you have more black friends?
Why don't I have more black friends? I didn't grow up with blacks.
I'm kidding.
That's funny, though. I probably have more black friends than I realize. Because a lot of blacks love and appreciate the truth. Well, yeah, a lot.
Well, there's quotas you have to hit, you know?
Right.
For diversity and inclusion.
You only need one.
No, I really wanted to ask you about if you've ever dealt with kind of like when you start waking up and I'm realizing my whole Christian family, I don't agree with any of them.
Yeah.
But we both say we're Christians. You know,
I know.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
I was just wondering if you've ever had to deal with that or if you had any thoughts on that or how to handle it or.
I mean, you don't have to hang around your family that much, but when you talk with them, just be honest with them. Don't pick a fight or try to seek out the drama. Don't hide from the drama. If they want to talk to you, talk to them. I've run into it a bit in some cases. Like, I remember one time, one of my relatives was, you know, sending me messages and trying to talk, and it was just, they were going overboard with it, so I just left it alone. And then come to find out, like, they love me. And I don't know if they agree with me completely, but I just left it alone because it was an unnecessary long conversation. It wasn't even necessarily an argument, but it was just a long, excessive thinking, intellectual disagreement. And I was talking with another friend of mine. These intellectual arguments about so-called truth, even though many of them are true, they don't really change minds. When you're doing it, or hearts or spirits, it doesn't change you. It doesn't change them. It's empty knowledge. It's just so shallow, even though they feel like it's the most important thing. Oh, this is theology. It's kind of like when I say, oh, I don't care about this flat earth, round earth, moon stuff, moon landing stuff. You don't care about God's creation? They try to act like it's the most important thing, right? But it's not. It's really unimportant. What's important is, like, the spirit. So...
No, that makes sense, because one of my brothers and I have had a couple arguments, and neither one of us really moves anywhere, so...
Yeah.
That makes sense, that it's like a waste of energy.
One thing that Jesse Lee Peterson said in church a couple weeks back is that when he was in debates, he doesn't try to win the debate. He just tries to put the truth out, and then whatever. And if people think that, oh, they won the debate or they destroyed Jesse, that's fine. Leave it alone. Don't get sucked into those ego battles. And don't try to convince anybody, because that's just forcing yourself on them. And that's not how you were opened up to the truth. Nobody forced the truth onto you. When you accepted it, you were looking for it.
Yeah, it's weird. It's almost like I heard it, I knew it was true.
Yeah.
Because I had heard other things before, and I was like, not this. And then eventually I heard it, and I don't know how to explain it other than when I heard it, I just knew it to be true.
Yeah. I don't know if anybody in JLP's family is totally agrees with him. Some of them agree with him more than others, but you don't expect anybody in your family or friends to agree with you. Don't require them to do it or anything.
Yeah. Well, just the couple times I've had arguments, I'm starting to see now that it's you can't convince anyone, and it's just kind of a.
Yeah.
If they ask you something, answer it, but you don't. I don't. Yeah. Because
it's
I don't need to go like, trying to pick fights or.
Yeah, I think it's God that opens their eyes. If you drive them away, you're just going to harden their hearts worse.
Yeah.
So you could be counterproductive.
Yeah. I probably have been, to be honest.
Yeah. I know how
but
that
I'm
is.
I'm starting to see that because I've had a few. Yeah, I've had a few talks, and after walking away, you do feel counterproductive. You feel like, man, it just doesn't go anywhere, and the person probably even thinks, maybe thinks less of you or just like hates you.
Yeah, I mean, if you're having fun with it, you mean no harm. You're not forcing it on them, but you're not subduing yourself. I don't know if subduing yourself is the right word. If you're not holding yourself back from being yourself, then you can be free, be you. And if they don't like you to be free and yourself, then you don't really have to be around them. At least not that much.
Yeah, it's just like this is it, take it or leave it and just move on.
Yeah. And then if they do want to hang out with you, but they don't want to hear it, then hang out with them and just small talk.
Yeah. That's probably the best course of action.
An hour.
Yeah, because I'm seeing when I first started. When I first started, I think I was picking fights, and now I think God's revealing that to me that, hey, this is not your job to go
right
pick fights with these people.
Yeah.
You need to cut that out. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate it, Drew. A lot of people relate to you. I definitely do, or have.
Yeah.
Still sometimes. Appreciate it, man. It's good to hear from you. I gotta go, though. Maybe we'll see you in Orlando this summer, if you're able to make it.
Yeah, I bought tickets, so hopefully I can show up. Hopefully work gives me the time off.
Right on. Put it in.
All right, sounds good.
All right, Drew.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. Take care. All right, guys. This has been the Hake Report. One thing that I forgot to mention was that the FBI... And we're over time. Called the terror attack on the congressman suicide by cop. I told you about it in Hake News. Check it out. Hake News for the end of hour two of the Jesse Lee Peterson show. And the FBI privately told these congressmen way back in 2017. It was June 2017 that this boomer or Gen X guy, a fan of Rachel Maddow or whatever... A hater of the president, a male Democrat. How cringe-worthy is that? Went and shot up these congressmen as they were practicing baseball. I forget if it was a handgun or a rifle. I think it was with a rifle. Shot him up, severely injured Steve Scalise. And then a cop shot him, killed him. He fired over like 100 rounds, I think. And they called it... I'll post it to my Telegram. Shout out Asmodor. He'll repost it. And they called it suicide by cop. It's hardly suicide by cop. But anyway, that's the liberal FBI for you. They have a double standard. They are anti-American. even inside of America. What a shame. I'm James Hake, thehakereport.com, jesseleepeterson.com for JLP stuff, rebuildingtheman.com for the men's conference, also jesseleepeterson.com for the men's conference. Either location has the link for you guys, men only. August 14th in Orlando, Florida. Buy your tickets early. Thanks, guys, and take care. We'll be right back.